Hello, this is Paul Goodman, and this is our video review of Starhawk.
This, it all started with a spark.
In the far future, humanity now travels the stars with the help of the dangerous but valuable Rift energy. Collecting Rift energy has essentially inspired a new gold rush, despite the fact that exposure to the Rift can turn you into a gibbering mutant if you're not careful. You play as a mercenary named Emmett, who's returned to his former home of White Sands, a small mining colony that's struggling to make ends meet and make their Rift quota before a trade ship arrives. However, it turns out a mutant known as the Outlaw has been organizing the Rift-mutated outcasts to wage war against White Sands, and it's up to Emmett to take them down for good. At its core, Starhawk is a third-person shooter, but with a unique mix of tower defense and arcade-like flight simulation thrown into the pot. Throughout the game's story campaign, you'll be airdropping in structures and turrets to fend off attacks or engage in aerial combat using the game's transforming hawks. While that may sound like an interesting setup for a sci-fi western, the unfortunate thing is that Starhawk's story campaign is pretty lackluster and generic. What few big reveals come along are fairly predictable, and in many ways it feels like nothing more than a prolonged tutorial from the game's multiplayer.
Last time I saw you, I think 10 years? And just like that, you're back, huh?
Starhawk's multiplayer component makes up the other half of the game, and is a fun, albeit slightly limited, experience. Focus on smaller scale skirmishes with about a dozen players on either side, you'll do battle against other players in a handful of modes ranging from deathmatch, capture the flag, or claiming control points in zones mode. The game's maps offer up a variety of different regions to battle in, from sandy dust bowls to orbital platforms, which lets you play around with a few different tactics and playstyles. I really liked how I could go from fierce dogfights and hawks to defending my team's base with a beam cannon to running down a flag carrier. Plus, constructing buildings is carried over from single player, which is a nice addition that separates Starhawk from other multiplayer shooters and lets you have some control over the layout of the game map. However, while the multiplayer is pretty solid, there are a few aspects you might find annoying. For example, there's a building limit that's spread out across your team, which means it can be impossible to build a much-needed turret, wall, or vehicle depot if you have a teammate who's used up all the slots building their own personal fortress in some random part of the map. It probably would have inspired more teamwork also if everyone had their own personal limit, or received bonuses for pairing up with someone to build a fortified bunker or outpost. Plus, sometimes it can be a little too easy for an opposing team to steamroll your base and spend an entire match blowing up you and your teammates as soon as you make landfall. Although, on that note, it is awfully fun to use your drop pod as a weapon and land on some poor unsuspecting schmuck from several thousand feet up. Boom! Overall, Starhawk's a good game, but once you get past all the transferring mechs and pretty explosions, it comes across as just an average shooter with a strong, if not slightly flawed, multiplayer component. If you're in the mood for a decent sci-fi western-themed shooter, and can get past the rather blah story, Starhawk is a respectable choice.
That looks like the last of them, Cutter.
There's not a scab in sight. That's how you earn a paycheck.
I've had it. The Rifters rebuild this worksite, and it never fails. The next day, those scabs tear it all down.
That often? It's more than a scab problem. We got new neighbors.